Uhuru Kenyatta to put his house in order. Patrick Amimo, KTN News.
Back to coronavirus stories, and this time some good news. Winnie Kamau, a data journalist, got back into the country from Sierra Leone in mid-March. And as she was self-isolating, reality dawned on her that she had contracted COVID-19. Our recovered Winnie now tells us her story to Najma Ismail.
Some guys came from the ministry, and I remember they did the test outside.
Outside your house?
Because they can't come into your house.
Yeah,
outside. Wow. The door, as in completely outside, you know, like entrance of your house. So they did that, and it was very uncomfortable and painful. Maybe after a day. So they put the swab inside your nose, like it has to get to the end until like here the ear. Yeah. You can imagine having something getting inside until here.
Yes.
And then they put the swab again into your throat, like. It has to go up to here. They have to get to your tonsils, like here. That's what you don't.
I know. Wow.
And they did five times because I was every time they would do it like
I know.
So finally, it's painful. The following day, so my chest started misbehaving again. Now it was really bad. So I called 719 again, and they told me the doctor who was there, who is this doctor? She told me to buy medicine.
What kind of medicine?
And to buy antibiotics. So I was to buy, she prescribed antibiotics and chloromycin antibiotics and paracetamol. Apparently, if you take ibuprofen, because that's what I had before, it clogs because it retains water in your chest, in your lungs, so it clogs it. Mm. But paracetamol helps to release. So I took that. And then before that, I had a meeting. I couldn't even speak. Like, you see the way we are speaking right now? I couldn't do this. Like, I wouldn't even